February is American Heart Month, and doctors are spreading the word about lowering the risk of heart disease. Awareness is important. Heart disease is the number one killer of women, taking more lives than all forms of cancer combined. And joining us now to talk more about it is Dr. Alan Zaharias of Washington University, interventional cardiologist at Barnes Jewish Hospital. Doctor, thanks so much for being with us. We appreciate it. Now, when we talk about women and heart disease, the way the symptoms present themselves are somewhat different than in men.
That is correct. So for traditional coronary disease or blockages of the arteries that feed the heart, women tend to have symptoms that are a little less specific or more diffuse than men. The classic chest pain or chest discomfort that radiates to the neck or to the shoulder is actually not present in women. And women more or less feel more fatigued or more short of breath, and they may potentially attribute it to other things other than the heart. Mm-hmm. So that's why we have to be aware of it.
So they may not recognize it right away if they're out of breath or if they're extra tired. So they should kind of take that as a warning that this may be something else.
That is correct. And sometimes because we miss those warnings, their outcomes may be less well when you compare them to men. Also, there may be more narrowings of the arteries that feed the heart, or potentially the arteries tend to shrink a little more, mm-hmm. which make their outcomes different than men.
Now, there are all kinds of treatments for heart disease, various stents, various operations. Valves are considered, the heart valves can become not functional.
Correct. So the most common cause of heart disease is narrowings of the arteries that feed the heart. However, the heart muscle can get diseased, or potentially the heart valves can also get diseased. Mm. Particularly as people grow older, there's a lot of inflammation, and potentially some of the valves, and particularly the aortic valve, may not be opening well. And as a result, these can lead to other symptoms of heart failure, swelling, shortness of breath, passing out, and eventually lead to death if this is not recognized and treated appropriately. And particularly in women, outcomes of valve replacements are a little different when compared to men. A group of physicians and myself do a procedure called transcatheter valve replacement, and we know that in high-risk patients, particularly women, tend to do better than men in their 30-day and one-year survival. Because of how the heart actually adapts better potentially to the valve, and there's a lot of leakage from the valve per mm-hmm. se after we, a lot less leakage from the valve per se after we do the procedure.
So for the lifestyle for a woman, it might be better after than a man after the valve replacement.
Correct, it turns out that their recovery is much better and or easier for them mm-hmm. after they survive the procedure.
Mm-hmm. Now, what can we do to prevent heart disease, either a man or a woman, and does it make a difference in men or women?
Prevention makes a difference in everyone. And the things that we can do to make sure that we don't develop or progress coronary disease or heart disease in general is know your numbers. You need to make sure your blood pressure is well controlled. You need to make sure that if you have diabetes, that your hemoglobin A1C or your sugar is appropriately controlled. If you have problems with cholesterol, that this is addressed appropriately, both with medicines and with diet. You have to eat well, exercise well, and potentially have minimize the amount of stress that that you encounter in life.
Mm-hmm. All right. Doctor, and if anybody wants to contact you, how may they do that? Through Washington University or Barnes?
So we have the Heart and Vascular Center at mm-hmm. Washington University School of Medicine and Barnes Jewish Hospital. It has a lot of cardiologists and cardiac surgeons that actually are always available to answer any questions and potentially see patients when they need to be seen in different areas of expertise.
Okay. That's Dr. Alan Zaharias. Thank you so much,
Thank you
for being
with
us.
Thank you very much for having me.